Crazo here made a video. So what I think I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna come off the top. It's gonna be like a Gary version. Okay, I'm gonna come off the top. I'm gonna listen to what she said, and I'm just gonna say something. And I'm gonna add this on. Let this be the beginning of what I promise, Crazo number one. And for all you people online that don't know what I'm talking about or who I'm talking about, who cares? All right. She starts off talking about her and Jacqueline Glenn are not our friends. This is not a beef between me and Jacqueline. But this is a beef between me and all y'all. Who cares? Y'all want some? Y'all know where to find me. Okay, she goes on talking, trying to make the comparison between a mental illness and somebody that's misogynistic, so on and so forth. She's just trying to, I don't know. Seems like she got a little temper tantrum. She's got some special feelings for people with mental illnesses. I guess she, I don't know. There's some connection with her. Okay, so the next, well, I don't know, 10 minutes is her talking about, I don't have no lawyers in my family, so legal terms, I don't even know why they brought that up. It beats me. Now you're talking about, you know, if he was coherent or not. Of course he was coherent. It amazes me how would, even reading the manifesto, she's pulling out excerpts from his manifesto, and it's like I don't think she even sees what it is that he is conveying at all. She doesn't see the turnout of what it's just like. It's interesting. Let's keep watching. Craze. Anybody else but Craze did, you know, was doing it. Craze and a few other people. You know, I would let it go. I'll let it ride. But no. There are certain standards that we must uphold. Seriously. And I feel you're gonna have to make a choice. Either the red pill or the blue pill. You can't stay on the fence trying to, that's what it seemed like to me. It seems like you're trying to stay on the fence. You're trying to be friendly with these people and friendly with, no. There's that, a house divided against itself will not stand. It just will not stand. I'm not going to do another Elliot Rodgers, but I'm going to start working on the series. In fact, I've already started. Let me show y'all the book. Let's see. Number one, Crazo. Yeah, ain't a lot of stuff in there though. I got some thoughts. I'll show y'all some stuff since this is the first one. I might make it just 10 minutes. Upload 10 minutes. Something like that. But here, let me see if I can get this recording real fast. It might not be that good. Check it out.
Does. I concluded that all women are flawed. There is their primal brain emotions and impulses. That is why they are attracted to barbaric, wild, beast-like men. They're beasts themselves. Beasts should not be able to have any rights in a civilized society. Women are like a plague. They don't deserve any rights. Their wickedness must be contained in order to prevent future generations from falling to degeneracy. Women are vicious, evil, barbaric animals, and they need to be treated as such. Women's rejection of me is a declaration of war, and if it's war they want, then war they shall have. It will be a war that will result in their complete and utter annihilation. And I mentioned before this fantasy, this ideal world of his.
Okay, she's reading that. I hope you got it. If you didn't get it, it's too bad. She's reading that like he really thought that stuff. I mean, read between the lines, please. Come on, this guy is, he knows his audience and he's catering to them. If you can't see that, I just, you know, even still, what he said is clear, but let's go on. Okay, now I'm gonna give you the highlight to get rid of this mind count thing. Oh man, she said it herself. Listen to what she said. This is what she said.
Insane. I mean, if you take Elliot Rodgers' manifesto and you put it side by side with Mein Kampf, he kind of sounds like he's Hitler's strange little cousin or something, only with a hatred redirected on women.
Now, if you take an educated person, right, and you, and they have a desire to eliminate a group of people, the first thing that will come to their mind historically is that infamous person, the most infamous person, most famous infamous person that they can think of. And this is what you're seeing in his betrayal of Hitler. It's not that he is literally in sync with the true evil that Hitler is. Is him drawing from his knowledge, drawing from his education, drawing from, you know, what he know to be his, you know, history, or what he knows illustrates how he feels. That's not him being, am I recording? That's not him being anywhere near like Hitler. I'm gonna go into it more. Here's the sad part. She's going into the law, and I know y'all already saw. If you didn't see it, then you, too bad. She's going into the law. Motive is the cause that moves people. All of this is her stepping down from logic. You know, it's like, are you serious? She's getting into some deep ground. This is where her desire to fight with the feminists is destroying her ability to think, I think. Because it's clear that his motive, period, was to not kill women, but what he say, sees the rejection of himself. You know, that was really what he was trying to do. But she didn't get that. Okay. She goes into him not being able to get into the sorority house. And I'm thinking, were there cops at the door? Where I'm from, it's like, if your intentions is to shoot up everybody in there, why not start with the people at the door? So if he couldn't get in, that's not, I know this is, I'm not using very, because I'm just like, I'm not trying to put much effort into the whole thing. But if he couldn't get into the door, that means he really wasn't trying hard enough. How you gonna walk around with ammunition and then you gonna let a door stop you? Tell me where they did that before, where true criminals have did that before. You know, you can pick this whole thing up, all of these comments and videos about Elliot Rogers and why he's a misogynist. They shouldn't even use that word. You know, on the next video, I think I'm just gonna, cause I'm like 13 minutes in on this, it's 21 minutes. And I'll probably use 20 minutes just to make this. So the next one, I'll probably just destroy misogyny. Yeah, that's what I'll do. I'll just cover that in the rest of these minutes. And I think I'm done with it. I'm just get into something else.